Hello and welcome to another Turbo Houdini Power Training. Here on Effects Hive, your channel for visual effects, animation, simulation and everything 3D related. Today we will look into some interesting toolkit you can use to create this kind of effect here. A sandblast explosion. As you might know, the new Dune movie is currently in production, and whenever you want to make some interesting explosion like sand or impact, you should grab this tool and make some interesting and awesome explosions. So how is this tool working actually? When you download it from the website, you have the ability here to use the input objects, and you have the pig head, the rubber toy, also a sphere is here, and I picked the test geo squab and piped it here into the mountain, which gets clips and polyfill and gets remeshed. And all this is getting down into the grain source magic, which you actually can see here. This is a representation of the squab laying on the ground, and it's pretty easy, pretty good and pretty easy to make those geometry and those emitters for your explosion. So what's important here is the noise attribute VOP, where you are able to control the noise amount of the explosion. I put it actually fairly high to an amplitude of 55 and a frequency of 5, and this is what's giving us this kind of fast and heavy impact here. As you can see here, it's fairly small, fairly tiny, because you can see it's the shape of the squab here. So actually you can take almost every emitter you want to use to make your sandblast. And the acid actually provides every single node you need to make your explosion interesting. We have a force ramp here where you can add the force amount to your sandblast, to your dune explosion. And we also have a wet sand here, which means that we can stick certain sand particles together, like you can see down here. And we also have the ready sand source file cache, and I will cache some explosion out now. I will pause the video, and then later on we're gonna render it with Redshift. You will get some Redshift information, some awesome tricks how you can render particles with Redshift inside Houdini. So keep watching and see you soon. So the first node has cached now, and I loaded it into the file cache here. The file cache can be used to load and save several and different file formats. And I'm now diving here in the sand sim node, and you can here see the forces of the actual explosion. I will change the time scale here to fairly lower, so it's a bit more slower, and we'll now cache the next node here. So I cached 50 frames, and you can see here the blast is pretty heavy. It it has some spikes over here that gives an idea of the velocity inside the destruction here. And it's actually interesting how you can do duplication of points here when you want to make more detail in your simulation. P scale can be adjusted, so you have a lot of options to tweak your sandblast and make it even more interesting, and which goes down over to the speed here. And we have a post sand cache where we can do all the changings we did here before. So we're gonna cache also some frames of that. Choose frame range, start to end, make 50 frames and save this to disk. So that's it for the creation of the particle part. We can also do some smoke simulation inside our system here. And this is what I'm gonna do in the next approach. But first, let's have a look at the rendering of our particles with Redshift. I change a camera here, and to use Redshift you have to make the installation accordingly to the Houdini information, because when you install Redshift it will not appear directly. You have to put some nodes inside the Houdini environment file, which is located on your computer, and once you have your Redshift ready, you create a render of Redshift here. I already made some adjustments to the Redshift settings here. We have motion blur, we have global illumination, I will use brute force, and I also assigned a Redshift material here for the grain particles, and it's actually very easy to use, and it's a very very fast renderer. I'm using an RTX 2070 card, and we'll now do a rendering here. So we go to the out section, open the render view, and I will give you some rendering now. And as you can see, it's already rendering. It's not the IPR rendering, because IPR is a bit confusing from the quality, especially when you render volumes and the smoke of the explosion. But here you can see how the particles are rendered. It's actually pretty impressive how fast it's compared to Mantra. And here we have the wet sand and everything else. And to adjust the material to the sand object, you go to to your object and press here the object parameter button, and then this Redshift OBJ appears here, and you can render the particles, render object as particles, and this is what makes your rendering, what makes you render the particles and the grain very easily and very fast. So I also have some light in the scene here, a sun and a dome light, and I will change the diffuse scale and the intensity multiplier. I have a dome light which you can use to also put HDRIs into your scene to make a different light behavior and light feeling, and to turn on and off the IPR, you go to your Redshift crop here on IPR and activate IPR rendering, and then we open IPR and it's directly using the card for the rendering. And as you can see now, I can pretty much change the light here to something lower, and it's automatically adjusting those settings in the IPR. So it's pretty handy when you want to have fast and interesting feedback for your scene in Redshift. And I'm very impressed by Redshift. I'm really thinking to get a version to render out some nice explosions. And as you can see here, I'm changing the perspective, and it's adjusting in the render setting very fast here. And this is what makes Redshift a very, very fast, very stable, very cool render engine. And you definitely should go and check it out, especially when you're looking for fast results, for good quality, and just for a quantum leap in rendering. And because Mantra is a nice render engine, but it's sometimes so slow, and with the power of an RTX card, or even with a 1080 card, you can get very interesting results in a very fast amount of time. And now I will show you some smoke rendering in Redshift. So I go into the dust tool here and will save my smoke simulation to disk. So I rendered some smoke here inside the simulation, and as you can see, it's looking pretty interesting. All the tiny pieces fly apart, and this is what you also can achieve with this toolkit here from the Digital Alchemist. And what I'm gonna do now is going to render the smoke with Redshift. And what you have to do is turning the smoke on, assigning here the object parameter button to your smoke object, and go to the volume, go to the material tab and assign the RS Redshift volume material. So let's see how this looks rendered. Go to the out, open the IPR.